Well, welcome to or welcome back to the 510 Report, where we talk about industry news, advocacy, and general goings-on. Thank you so much for joining me again. So the first thing I wanted to mention today is Aaron Bieber, the director of the tobacco harm reduction documentary A Billion Lives, is currently Kickstarter funding a new film titled You Don't Know Nicotine, Why Young People Shouldn't Use It, and Why Some Adults Should. The Kickstarter campaign, as of this recording, is sitting right at around $29,000 of the $50,000 goal. Now, the vision of the film, according to the Kickstarter page, nicotine is a very complicated molecule. Historically, it was mainly found in harmful cigarette smoke. In recent years, the use of clean nicotine without smoke has been growing due to the changes in technology. Many are using nicotine to quit smoking. Despite a historic drop in teen smoking rates, nicotine use by young people is on the rise. Many do not understand the actual risks. With all of the media hype surrounding nicotine, it's time to end the harmful misinformation and educate the public on what nicotine is, isn't, and what should be done with it. We will answer three big questions during this 75-minute eye-opening journey. How does nicotine actually affect developing brains? Are there any benefits to adults who use nicotine without smoking? Who's covering up the truth about nicotine and why? We will chase down as many experts, willing and unwilling, as our budget allows. It's time to get answers from all sides of this debate. Education surrounding nicotine and less harmful vapor products is pretty critical, especially in this political climate. I think this is an incredible project. I'm going to be donating to it, and I would love to see Aaron and his team surpass that $50,000 goal and really make this movie the big deal that it deserves to be. I'll have links down in the description to both Aaron Bieber's Twitter and the Kickstarter campaign for this movie if anybody is interested in contributing to this really important project. Honestly, this is one of those situations where every little bit helps. So shifting gears from that just a little bit, the official FDA tobacco Twitter account sent out this tweet on January 28th. Reminder, submit comments, research data, and other information related to youth e-cigarette use and drug therapies to help addicted youth quit e-cigs by February 1st, 2019. February 1st, 2019 is this Friday. And just as a real quick side note, my favorite reply to this particular tweet was from a user named M. Penn, and he said, "There's a pill for everything, even pills for side effects of other pills. Pills keep America happy or sad. Pills are America." Very accurate observation, M. Penn. Very accurate, and also very sad as well. The link provided will take you to the FDA.gov website where it reads, "We solicit information and comments announced in the Federal Register and posted in dockets on regulations.gov from concerned citizens, industry, and organizations on a wide range of issues related to implementation of the Tobacco Control Act." The Tobacco Control Act that they're talking about here is the 2009 Family Smoking Prevention and Tobacco Control Act, which was signed into law by then President Obama. This is the act that gave the FDA the power to regulate the content, the marketing, and the sale of all tobacco products in the United States, including less harmful vapor products. Yeah, thanks, Obama. I'll be providing a link down in the description of this video that will take you directly to the Federal Register where comments can be submitted. And I really truly apologize for not mentioning this in an earlier 510 report, but I personally didn't see this information until just a few days ago. The timeline is incredibly tight. So if you want to get a comment in, it basically has to be done within the next 48 hours. Now, I don't know if anybody else remembers the last time that the FDA had an open comment period like this, back when they were discussing the possible prohibition of all flavors within far less harmful vapor products. This is the same Federal Register, which is a federally run and owned and operated website, by the way, that was hit with over 250,000 fake anti-vaping spam comments. Evidently, this 250,000 fake spam anti-vaping comments were all submitted over the course of about 3 days before it was caught. And the bots submitting these spam fake anti-vaping comments were all traced back to 4 IP addresses. And a lot of these spam comments were just copy-pasted from other people submitting comments, like the Campaign for Tobacco-Free Kids. There was an ongoing investigation being handled by the FDA to determine whether or not these spam comments would be accepted or rejected officially. I don't believe we've heard a decision either way, but here's to hoping that that doesn't happen again, which it's a really weird thing to me to say that I hope a federally owned website doesn't get hacked and spammed again. The Chick-fil-A drive-thru down the street is more efficient than the federal government change my mind. Brent Stafford over there at Regulator Watch already did a fantastic news report on this very story. I'll have a link below down in the description to that video, which I think everybody should check out. Two last things that I wanted to mention this week. One is some new legislation popping up in the state of Colorado. HB 1076 in Colorado is sort of a one fell swoop type of legislation. It's being presented as an update to the already established Colorado Clean Indoor Air Act. If passed, it will ban all flavored vapor products in the state of Colorado, as well as adding new taxes to both e-liquid and hardware. At what rate, I don't know yet. And it will ban all indoor vaping, including inside retail vape shop locations. There is no current CASA call to action on this, so I would encourage every vapor living in the state of Colorado to contact your elected officials regarding HB 1076. Down in the description, I'll provide the contact information for the four representative co-sponsors of this bill. Remember that these representatives work for you, so make your voice heard and oppose this very anti-public health bill. Now, this last bit of news that I wanted to talk about just feels strange and icky. Right now, listed on the talent casting website backstage.com is a casting call for children aged 10 to 14, I think we know where this is going, to appear in a New York anti-vaping campaign. This casting call is being organized by a website called scarymommy.com. And scarymommy.com is one of these new sort of Gen Z millennial parenting advice websites and communities. Their slogan is parenting doesn't have to be perfect. According to the backstage.com description, a public service anti-vaping campaign for print is seeking young talent. The spots will encourage parents and kids to not use vaping products. The campaign is seeking male and female Asian talent aged 10 to 14 for close-up portrait photography with an ice cream cone. Minors must have parental or guardian approval and accompaniment at the shoot. Shooting will take place for one day during March at an outdoor location in Brooklyn. Talent will be paid $1,200 for the day. Now, apart from the disgustingness of parading your kids around to be in an anti-vaping ad, not knowing themselves really what they're being a part of, the fact that these spots will encourage kids and adults to not use e-cigarettes. Now, I am all for encouraging kids to not use vapor products, assuming that the information that they're being educated with is truthful and factual. But I am sorry, telling an of-age adult smoker that they shouldn't use e-cigarettes is the opposite of helping public health. And I guess where I land on this is I find it kind of genuinely disturbing that parents, not doctors or scientists, but parents are trying to influence this public health legislation and sort of try to legislate morality. These wealthy suburban helicopter parents and moms who couldn't possibly imagine that their little angel would ever experiment with nicotine are dangerous opponents to public health and are perfectly okay with taking your rights away as an adult in order to protect their little angel living in their overly coddled Nerf world. They couldn't stop their kids, but they want to stop your kids because they know what's best. This is one of those things that is genuinely scary to me. There are more and more of these sort of like righteous parent groups sort of springing up in the United States. I mean, we have Scary Mother here as an example. There is the Mothers Against Vaping organization as well as the Parents Against Vaping organization. I am all for educating the youth and preventing the youth from getting access to these vapor products. But I will honestly be damned if I am going to let some rich, suburban, clueless mother dictate how I get to live my life. The Parents Against Vaping organization is actually on Twitter if you wanted to communicate them and engage with them, respectfully, of course. And that right there is actually the last thing that I wanted to touch on in this week's 510 report. When we're engaging with doctors and scientists and elected officials in sort of a public forum, whether that's on Twitter or Facebook or any other social media, we need to be calm and respectful. I know that desire to reach through the screen and just grab Scott Gottlieb by his head and shake him around and just say, "What is wrong with you?" But we're not going to get anywhere by casting accusations, calling people names, or just publicly telling the FDA to fuck off. And I know it feels really good to say that, but it's very counterproductive and it's not constructive or helpful to our cause in any way. Let's be educated, let's be armed with the facts, and let's present those facts in a reasonable and civil way. And I think right there is actually where we are going to end this 510 report today. As always, I would love to get any of your thoughts down in the comments below. And of course, we're not going to end this 510 report without also mentioning CASA.org. Please go sign up. It's free. It's easy. All you need is an email. If you want to know about negative vape legislation coming up in your particular city, area, or state, CASA.org. Follow those calls to actions. We are getting into a brand new legislative season, and things are going to be popping up in states and cities across the country. It's going to feel overwhelming to all of us, but we cannot lose hope. We have science on our side. We have numbers on our side. And as Kevin Skipper always said, you don't have to do everything, but you do have to do something. Let's get involved.